Welcome, everyone.
Oh, yes. Wake up, Beacon. Here we are.
Wake up, Beacon.
And it is Friday. Friday.
I'm here with Miss Allie, as always.
Yes, and I'm here with Mr. Lee. How are you doing, Mr. Lee?
Good. I got my coffee. I'm good to go. So now you can talk to me.
Oh, fantastic. It is quite early. It's like 5:30 in the morning.
Oh. How are you doing?
I'm doing delightful. I'm really excited to be here.
I can understand why, because it's our 30th episode.
30 episodes. Can you guys believe it? It seems like only 5 episodes ago, your brother was trying to take over the show.
That's because it was 5 episodes ago.
I have no concept of time anymore.
Is your brother going to take over the show again and try to use me as his heir?
No. In fact, I asked him to record a video stating exactly that.
Roll it.
Mm-hmm. Oh. Hi, kids. Greetings, Mr. Lee. From the real Mr. Lee. I promised during the summer to not try to steal your show. Or put Greg on my head. My beautiful, beautiful head. For now. Unless, Greg, you might need a place to stay over the summer, in which case... Think about it. We shall meet again, Beacon.
Ooh.
That doesn't sound good.
No.
I think we're good for this week, though.
Yes.
Yeah.
Maybe instead of him asking for Greg, he can just, like, grow hair of his own.
I don't think he can. Anyway, Greg, how are you doing?
Hello, everyone. And hello, Miss Allie. I'm used to seeing you behind the camera, so it's fun to see you on the show. I'm doing well. I hit a patch of writer's block, though, and I had a hard time writing a song this week.
Oh no!
Greg, so did you get a song written?
I mean, everybody goes through writer's block.
Yeah, and last week's song was great.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I know. I have a song, but I really had to dig deep to write it. I hope the effort comes across.
Oh, I'm sure it will, Greg.
Now, and Tammy, how are you doing?
Yeah. You still making the big move back to sunny California?
Yeah, I am, for now. I'll spend some time this summer with my family tree, and then we'll just see what happens next year. But us three will stay in touch, right?
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Oh, of course, yes.
Yeah.
Oh, for sure.
Well, we better get going on this show, Allie.
Yes, we have a jam-packed schedule.
Jam-packed.
Like, so busy.
There's no Brian the Brain this week. He went on vacation.
Sorry, Senorita Patterson.
Yeah, she's a big fan.
Big fan.
He went to the Hamptons, which is where all the fancy pants people live.
I wonder if he drinks his tea like this, but they have the pinky out.
Oh, probably.
No.
Oh,
and you had that call with your childhood friend this week.
Yes, we have a feature this week. We're going to interview one of my friends that has kind of a cool job. I've known her since we were like 6 or 7 years old. So that was like 20 years ago.
What grade would you have been in?
First.
So first graders, listen up.
Yeah. She is an illustrator. She draws for books.
Wow.
And so let's go talk to her right now.
Yes, straight to the next segment.
Hey, Carrie.
Hey, Mr. Lee.
How's it going?
It's going great. I'm glad to be on your show because I am a fan.
Oh, and I'm a fan of yours, and this is your new book, and we're going to be talking about this book, and Greg is going to be reading it for story time right after we're done talking.
So awesome. I love Greg and Tammy.
Okay, so do you mind telling us about New Bird in Town?
I would love to. First, I get the manuscript. That's the story. So it's just typed up, and I get to read it and decide, do I love it or do I hate it? And if I love it, I illustrate it. So this book I really loved. So one of the next things I do, I have to design the characters, which is my favorite part.
Mm-hmm.
So here's just some other characters I've done for other things. And I love animals, and this book is full of animals. So research is the next thing that I have to do. Lots of research sometimes. Now, this book has a barred owl in it, also known as a hoot owl. So they're very cool birds. So then I start sketching. And just trying to see what I want the character to look like. And I really loved this little drawing where this owl is reading Harry Potter and he has his Gryffindor scarf, and he even has the little scar on his forehead. And I was just kind of having fun, because that's the best way to do this kind of work, is to have fun. But I really like this owl, so it became the style of the owl from that point on. So then I got to do the other characters. So this helps me to put them all in a row. Then I see how tall they are next to each other. That helps me draw them sometimes 100 times in the same way. So owl got changed a little. They didn't really like the rectangle glasses, but they wanted them to be round. So I did make that change. Then I do what's called pagination, which rhymes with
imagination.
So that's the page layouts. So this is what those look like. They wanted this too to look like a comic book. So it has lots of panels, and that was hard. It took a long time to do this. But here's me figuring out maybe the panels I want to use and maybe what's on them. This is all I need to do to figure out then how to make all of the drawings for the book. So here's all the drawings for this book, Mr. Lee. Wow. It's a lot. So this took probably 3 months to draw everything.
What do you draw it with?
These are just pencil sketches.
So they're actually pencil on paper?
Pencil on regular paper. I don't like to draw in the computer. So here's some of those sketches with just my pencil. And I love this part too. And like this drawing I really like, they were getting ready for a party, but then they ended up not using it. So sometimes I do a lot of work that doesn't get into the book. And then this is what an entire 2-page spread, this is called, looks like, with everything in there and the text for the story and the bubbles.
So do you write the text of what they say, or is that done by someone else?
That's in the manuscript. That's right. Told to me which character is speaking.
The actual writing of the words, do you do that, or is that printed by?
That's printed. Later. That's a typeface.
You just have to make the space for it.
Mm-hmm.
See.
And then I'll show you what the final art looks like. I used Photoshop a lot, and you can see here, all of these layers are here. That's how I'm going to have to build this artwork. And sometimes there's 100 or more layers. For everything I do in here, it gets a layer. So there's a lot of them.
Wow.
So this was my first practice one where I'm just playing with the tool to see how I want to use it. Mm-hmm. And then here's a little bit more finished one. So I'll show you what it looks like as I build this. Now, right here, you see what looks like watercolor, right, Mr. Lee?
Yep.
So what I did was create little paintings with just some gray, and I wanted it to look painted, but most of this book is not painted at all. So I used a little bit of this texture, and then I can change it into any color. So kind of looks like this when I start getting going. This is done with a special digital pad and a digital pen or a paint brush. And so I have to start adding on layers, and I just keep building them up. And notice this, here's a fun fact, Mr. Lee, that barred owls, depending on how many crayfish they eat, will make them really pink on their bellies.
Oh, so, really?
Yeah, like, I learned that. So his belly turns pink, and then it changes throughout the book because of that.
Oh, really? Wow. Just like flamingos.
Like flamingos.
The shrimp. That's why they're pink.
So here, the deck, you can see it looks like a piece of wood. It's because I took a picture of a piece of wood. So I have a lot of digital textures, it's called. Huh. So I'll just kind of keep filling in a little bit.
So do you go around and take pictures of things just for their texture?
I do.
You just kind of find stuff, or do you actually go looking for?
I'll go find cool textures or just walk around my house. Once I used my sweater to make a texture. So whatever I can find, I use. So you can see lots of details now are coming in here. And then I did make this. This was the only other real paint I did for the trees. This was watercolor. And I used that for my trees. And then just putting in the shadows. You can see me doing paint or the digital paint for the shadows. And then the text for this story. So this page looked like this. Wow. So here's just a
last. A lot of work goes into it.
A lot of work. But I love it so, so much.
Well, that was really awesome, Carrie. Thank you for showing us. And now we're going to read your book. I hope you're not nervous. I think the kids are going to like it, though.
I think they will, too.
Hopefully Greg does a good job and does your book proud.
I bet he will.
Well, thanks for sharing what you do. It was really super interesting. I learned some stuff. And it was great seeing you. And I'll see you soon.
Okay. Bye.
That was super interesting.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. I was interesting and I was in it. And I still have learned something.
Right? Learn something new every time. I didn't even know that their bellies got pinker.
Yeah, because of the crayfish. Fascinating.
Yes, fascinating.
Well, now it's time to actually read that book.
So fun.
That means it's story time.
Jamie L.B. Dinaham and Mr. Lee's friend, Carrie Hartman. With the help of his forest estate agent, Owl found the perfect home. It had everything he needed, except new friends. When Owl spotted his neighbors, he called out his friendship song that sounded a lot like, "Who cooks for you? Who cooks for you all?" Do you hear that? Someone's calling out. Up there. What's that? Let's find out. The new bird's a barred owl. Owls are predators, and they prey from their perch, and mostly eat small mammals. We're small mammals! When no one called back, Owl swooped down to introduce himself. He tried to blend in. Move away. And offered to share his favorite food. The new bird needed a new plan. He made invitations. Dear neighbors. Decorated his tree. And put on his favorite party outfit and his friendliest face. Hey, that's the picture we saw being made. Dear neighbors, I'd love to have you all for dinner tonight at my tree warming party. Your neighbor, Owl. I smell a trap. Me two, me three. The new bird wants to eat us for dinner. Maybe have our friends for dessert. We better keep a close eye on him. Oh, I love parties. Owl waited and waited and waited. I'll never make new friends. Who cooks for you? Boo-hoo-hoo. Boo-hoo-hoo. Hi. Help, a skunk. Please don't spray me. Wait, are you going to spray me?
No. Were you planning to eat everyone at your tree warming party?
No, I prefer crayfish.
I'm sorry I scared you.
I'm sorry I panicked. Your stripe makes you look tough.
I only spray when I'm in danger. There's something different about your feathers.
When I eat a lot of crayfish, they turn pink. When I call out, I'm hoping for a friend who will call back to me. Want to try it sometime?
Yes. I'd love to be your friend.
The new bird has skunk trapped. She's doomed. Poor skunk. He'll eat her for dinner. Skunk sandwich, skunk salad, skunk soup. And then he'll eat us. Mouse mousse, bat brownies, possum pudding.
Possum pudding? Oh no. Possum!
Grasp. Don't eat us! There's no meat on these wings. Eat him! Huh? Back off, new bird. I know karate. I don't want to eat you. You don't? I want to be friends. Oh, well, thanks for saving me. This is embarrassing. Awkward.
Did not see that coming.
I don't really know karate. Owl's new friends walked him home. You want to see my new place?
Yeah!
Do you know many owls nest in large tree hollows like this one?
Possums are the only marsupials in North America. And bats are the only mammals that can fly. All the excitement tired Owl out. The new bird needed a nap. His friends tucked him in. I like having Owl around. Me too. Me three. We should do something nice for him. A party? Oh, I love parties. When Owl woke up, Skunk wasn't the only new friend waiting to give him a proper welcome. Who cooks for you? Who cooks for you all? We cook for you! That's who! Owl's new home was perfect. It had everything he needed, including friends. Who's that? Let's find out. The end.
Awesome. Good job, Greg.
Yes, fantastic job, as always.
I love seeing, you know, that picture she showed us, how she made it. I love seeing it in the book. It was so cool.
And the watercolor and the details in there, just fabulous.
You know what else is fabulous?
Tell me.
Weekend workout.
Yes.
Weekend workout. This week I have Miss Paulson's third grade class and we're going to dance to the YMCA. Now I think all of you probably know the moves to this, so dance along. Let's go.
Rachel's third grade class.
That was awesome.
Working up a sweat. Oh. So hard.
I'm tired just watching.
Yeah, falling asleep.
That's about almost the end of the show, except you know what time it is.
Is it time for maybe some singing?
Yeah, it's time for Greg Sings.
Again.
Hello, everyone. It's that time of year. Let's go. Everyone, it's time. It's the end of the year. Everyone, it's time for the end of the year. Don't forget all your books. Don't forget to grab your coat. Don't forget all you learned.
Maybe this summer you'll ride a boat. Everyone, it's time. It's the end of the year. Everyone, it's time for the end of the year.
Ooh, good job.
Wow. Excellent.
That's going to be stuck in my head the rest of the year.
Probably the rest of the school, too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I hope so. Good job, Greg. And I want to point out, you know, the Greg's main songwriting partner,
yes,
Chad.
Yes, shout out to Chad.
Is my non-evil brother.
Now, is he older or younger?
He's younger. Mm. Yeah. But yeah, he's a pretty good musician.
Yes.
Professional, you might say.
Oh. Wow.
Well, that That's about cool. does it. Have a good weekend, Beacon. Thank you, Allie, for co-hosting with me.
Thank you so much, and I'm surprised that it went as well as it did.
I'm not. Illustrator Carrie, want to take us home?
Oh, yeah. One last thing.
Oh, hot soup.